But there is a night, ayyuhal ikhwa, that each and every one of us should be extremely concerned about. There is a night, brothers and sisters, that each and every one of us should spend our days and nights thinking over, worrying, and pondering concerning how that night will be. And that night, brothers and sisters, is the first night in the grave. أول ليلة في القبر. That is the night, brothers and sisters, that we should be concerned about. That night, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam informed us in detail concerning it. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as occurs in the hadith of Al-Bara ibn Azib, Bara ibn Azib, he mentioned that on an occasion, خرجنا مع رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إلى جنازة. That indeed we went with the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم to a janaza. And the affair, or the term janaza, it is sound to say janaza بالفتح and janaza بالكسر. He said that we went with the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم to a janaza. فجلس رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم على القبر مستقبل القبلة. He said the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he sat يعني at the side of the grave facing the قبلة. وجلسنا حوله, and we all sat around him. وكان صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام, he would attend the janaiz. But on this occasion, the grave had not yet been dug, that they were digging the grave. And so Al-Bara ibn Azib رضي الله عنه, he said كأن على رؤوسنا الطير وهو يلحد له. He said it was as though there were birds on our heads. That is, we sat that still. It was as though there were birds on our heads that we didn't want to fly away. And the grave was being dug. He said, فجعل ينظر إلى السماء وينظر إلى الأرض وجعل يرفع بصره ويخفضه ثلاثا. He said, and the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he began looking at the sky, and then he would look down at the ground, and then he looked at the sky, and he looked down at the ground, and he raised his head and lowered it three times. فقال أعوذ أو قال استعيذ روايتان, that he said أعوذ, or he said استعيذ, he said I seek refuge in, or he said you should seek refuge بالله من عذاب القبر مرتين أو ثلاثا. He said that you should seek refuge in Allah Azza wa Jal from the punishment of the grave. And he said it twice or thrice. And then the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said again, أعوذ بالله من عذاب القبر, three times. Then Bara ibn Azib رضي الله عنه, he said that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إن المؤمن إذا كان في إقبال من الآخرة وانقطاع من الدنيا تنزلت إليه الملائكة كأن على وجوههم الشمس. He said when the believer is leaving the dunya and heading towards, or entering the akhirah, entering the hereafter, he said angels come down upon him, and it is as though these angels have the sun in their faces. Yani their faces are bright and illuminated. He said, مع كل واحد منهم كفنون. He said, each and every one of them, they have the shroud. They possess with them a shroud. And some versions mention a shroud from the shrouds of Jannah. He said, فجلسوا منه مد البصر. And so then they sit behind him and behind his head as far as the eye can see. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, ثم يجيء ملك الموت. He said, then the angel of death comes. He said, حتى إذا خرج روحه, until he removes the soul. And some versions mention detail in relation to the removing of the soul, that it leaves the body as water leaves a watering skin. He said that when the soul it leaves, صلى عليه كل ملك بين السماء والأرض وكل ملك في السماء. He said, when his soul leaves, then indeed every angel that is between the heavens and the earth, they make dua, they supplicate for him. And every angel in the heavens supplicates for him. وَفُتِحَتْ لَهُ أَبْوَابُ السَّمَاءِ. And the doors of the heavens are opened for him. وَلَيْسَ مِنْ أَهْلِ بَابٍ إِلَّا وَهُمْ يَدْعُونَ اللَّهِ. He said, and there is no custodian of any of the doors of the heavens except that they supplicate to Allah Azza wa Jal, يعني for that soul. Mentions, أَنْ يُعْرَجَ بِرُوحِهِ مِنْ قِبَلِهِمْ فَإِذَا عُرِجَ بِرُوحِهِ قَالُوا ربي عبدك فلان. He said that all of them supplicate to Allah Azza wa Jal that that soul may come in his direction. And when the soul reaches to that angel, he says, oh my Lord, your servant fulan, your servant such and such. He mentions, فيقول أرجعوه, that they say, return him. فإني أحدت إليهم أني منها خلقهم وفيها أعيدهم ومنها أخرجهم تارة أخرى. He says, and in some versions, when it reaches the seventh heaven, after the soul is inscribed in the register, Illiyin, the register for the righteous, that Allah Azza wa Jal says, return him to it. For indeed, I have laid down a decree that from it I have created them. That is from the turab and from the earth. From it I have created them. And indeed, فيها أعيدهم, and to it I shall return them. ومنها أخرجهم تارة أخرى, and from it I shall resurrect them on a further occasion. قال, فإنه يسمع خفق نعال أصحابه. And then he hears the stepping of the shoes and the sandals of his companions. إذا ولوا عنه فيأتيه آت فيقول من ربك ما دينك من نبيك. He said, and when they turn away from him, then an angel comes to him. Here he mentions آت, يعني an individual comes to him. And of course in other riwayat it mentions an angel, or they mention that an angel comes to him and asks him, who is his Lord? Who is your Lord? What was your deen? And who was your prophet? فَيَقُولُ رَبِّيَ اللَّهِ ودين الإسلام ونبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. He said that he will say, my Lord is Allah, my deen is Islam, and my messenger or my prophet was Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. And so some riwayat mentioned that he will repeat that, and the servant, he shall repeat it. And then the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and listen, ikhwan, to this statement. The messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, wa hiya akhiru fitnatin tu'radu 'ala al-mu'min. He said, and that is the last fitna. That is the last fitna that the mu'min will be exposed to. That is the last trial that the mu'min will be exposed to, no doubt, as it relates to the dunya, as it relates to the dunya as we know it. That is the last trial that the mu'min will be exposed to. Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, فَذَٰلِكَ حِينَ يَقُولُ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلْ يُثَبِّتُ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِالْقَوْلِ الثَّابِتِ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ. That is when Allah Azza wa Jal, and that is the meaning of the statement of Allah, that Allah Azza wa Jal will make the believer and those who believe firm, or give them the firm statement in the life of this world and in the Akhirah. فَيَقُولُ رَبِّيَ اللَّهُ وَدِينِيَ الْإِسْلَامِ ونبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم فيقول له صدقت ثم يأتيه آت حسن الوجه طيب الريح حسن الثياب. He said, and then another individual will come to him with a beautiful face and with a good fragrance adorning a beautiful garment. And so he will say, أبشر بكرامة من الله ونعيم مقيم. And he will say, give glad tidings with nobility from Allah, ونعيم مقيم, and an everlasting existence, an everlasting life. فيقول وأنت بشرك الله بخير من أنت. And he will say, and you, may Allah give you the glad tidings of good, who are you? And so he will say, ana amaluka salih kunta wallahi sari'an fi ta'ati Allah bati'an an ma'siyati Allah fajazaka Allahu khayran. He will say, and indeed I am your righteous actions. For indeed you used to be, wallahi, quick. Listen again to what he says to him. You used to be, by Allah, quick to the obedience of Allah, slow and hesitant to commit sin. فَجَزَاكَ اللَّهُ خَيْرًا. And so may Allah Azza wa Jal reward you with good. فَيُفْتَحُ لَهُ بَابًا مِنَ الْجَنَّةِ وَبَابٌ مِنَ النَّارِ فَيُقَالْ هَذَا كَانَ مَنْزِلَتَكْ لَوْ عَسَيْتَ اللَّهِ. He said that indeed a door then will be opened to him to Jannah, and a door to the hellfire. And it will be said to him, this would have been your abode had you disobeyed Allah. He mentioned, أَبْدَرَكَ اللَّهُ بِهِ هَذَا. And Allah Azza wa Jal exchanged this for this. He mentions, فَإِذَا رَأَى مَا فِي الْجَنَّةِ قَالَ رَبِّي عَجِّلْ قِيَامَ السَّاعَةِ كيما أرجع إلى أهلي ومالي فيقال له أسكن. He said that indeed he will say, and it will be said to him, or he will say, oh my Lord, hasten the establishment of the hour that I may return to my family and to my possessions. And it will be said to him, be tranquil. Ya'ani, have composure and tranquility in this abode until that time. This, brothers and sisters, is what the Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam informed us concerning the first night of the believer in the qabr. Walhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen.